Hey guys, I hope you're doing well. Okay, I realize it's Tuesday, but this throw is for the week of the 9th. So, I'm sorry, the 10th, the week of the 10th. So, I'm going to break it down towards where we are now, towards the middle of the week and towards the end of the week. And I'm going to try my best to get these done on a Saturday so we all have ample times no matter what time zone you're in. Okay, so we've got all Arcana cards here. Okay, and Saturn is direct. So, I think that what will happen or somehow come up in this is, okay, what have we learned here, right? How bad do we want the carnage to be and what have we learned, right? In all regards. So this is general. Take it for whatever area of your life that it fits, okay? We come in with the Strength card. Okay. And underneath it is the Three of Coins. Okay. I'm just going to pop that out here because I have a feeling I know where this is going. All right. We've got the Chariot card. Towards where we're at now, okay? And again, this is where I really think, what have we learned here, right? And we've got, in the middle part of the week, we've got the Tower card, right? And the end of the week, we've got the Hermit in reverse, okay? So, the question again, I think that what the throw is about, really, it's about thought versus impulse. Right? Were those words really coming out of my mouth? Did I think before I speak? What should I do here? Right? This is about, I feel, really trying to take the high road. If you're pushing through something, I'm going to say this is not a time to quit. Just get through the hard stuff, put in the work. Don't break your daily routines. Try to keep those things on track. Even the things that you're not really keen on doing, try to keep a disciplined order about those things. I think you're going to be pleasantly surprised, okay, at how that turns out. Push through things. Again, not a time to quit. Patience. Be patient with yourself and realize that things take time to come together, okay? Again, for some of you, I think this is passions versus conflicts, right? Is this really worth my time and my energy? Is it really worth what I want? Am I going in the right direction here, right? I think towards the middle of the week, you kind of get a bolt of aha on this, and that's for good or bad, okay? Either way, it's really just an awareness of it. So if it hits you in a way where, I'm kind of feeling negative about this, it might mean that you need to course correct. That's kind of what the Tower card can mean. Or maybe I'm taking on too much and I can't focus on what I thought my routine was. The middle of the week with the Tower card too is a good time to check in with what your, don't hold yourself so rigid to, I'm going to say don't give up on plans. Let me better say this. Keep your routines, but be tweakable. You know what I mean? If you realize at the beginning of the week, I set these goals for the week, but towards the middle of the week, things take precedence. Things from the beginning of the week, say, take longer and they're overflowing into things in the middle of the week. What happens is we reshuffle then the structure of what our to-do list is, right? Because now the new middle of the week is what I'm carrying from the beginning of the week. Things like that happen, but where we screw ourselves up with our routines and with our to-do lists is we're like, oh, I can't do this because it's off of what I thought I would do because now the middle of the week is now the end of the week. And what am I supposed to do with the end of the week? Just trickle it down. It doesn't need to be written in stone. If something is taking longer, don't breeze through it. Give it the attention that it's due, but then just carry your list a little bit forward. So what if the middle of the week has to, you know, now share a little space with the beginning, move the middle to the end, just shift it down. Use your, you know what I'm saying? Don't give up on things because they're not going exactly how you thought they were. This is where we give ourselves a little bit of wiggle room here and we get it done anyway. It really just turns out the way it's supposed to turn out. But when we abandon ship, we don't get out of the gate, right? And we're very unorganized at that point. All right. And at the end of the week, we've got the Hermit in reverse here. Okay. So those again are our impulses. My routine is going bad. Normally, maybe I would have just given up on something. Maybe I would have just given up on the whole list. I wouldn't have critiqued it. I would have just given up on it. With the Hermit in reverse here, it's just saying restructure your plan. That's all. Just restructure your plan. Okay. For others of you in relationships, I'm going to say this. I think that you've got someone who's coming at you like gangbusters here. Or you're coming at someone like that. With Venus retrograde here, that's probably not a good idea. The Chariot card is a card of, on a good day, I've got it together. I'm going to choose my words. Other days, it's like, you know, running through the village with a pitchfork. So just keep an eye on that, okay? Again, the Strength card can really be someone not knowing the difference between strength and force, right? And again, what have we learned from Saturn, right? Because there's instant karma smackdown with this. So if someone's coming at you like that, don't engage in it. If you're coming at someone like that, try to catch yourself, right? Because the Hermit in reverse with the Tower card in the middle can mean I'm repeating old patterns. Cut yourself again, though, some slack and realize that I'm only as able to course correct this as resilient as I am. So once you catch it, make that your new, I've caught it. So be grateful for that, right? Don't beat yourself up. Because I have the feeling here that you start out at the beginning of the week with things looking really great. And then as life happens, our plans change and you abandon ship. Don't do that. Just critique your day. Make life simple for yourself, okay? So that's what I kind of see here. Again, with the Tower, I feel for relationships, there may be conversations there that are harder than you had anticipated, right? But still, have them. You know, get them out on the table. Again, the Hermit card is, again, I think it came up in one of our readings about don't cut yourself off here. Get yourself re-engaged in life. If you're someone that works at home, say, try to start doing things that engage you more in your community. Get out there. Get your, you know, I'm not talking about online social media. I mean, get dressed, get your clothes on and get outside, right? There's sometimes people will, and I do it myself. I'll look down at 5 o'clock and I'm still in what I woke up in. We don't want to do those things. And something that, you know, passed my way recently is I don't know if I was oblivious to this or I just never noticed it or people are just starting to do it. But, and again, I'm not passing judgment, but I'm pointing something out here that if you're not investing in yourself, someone else is not going to invest in you either. And I'm not talking aesthetics for aesthetics, superficial, vain reasons. I'm talking about at what point do you give up on yourself that you're walking around now in a grocery store or in a bank in your pajamas and slippers? I don't know if I've never noticed this before or if it's just something that's happening, okay? But again, it's little tweaks like that, you know, like at what point did, if you're asking for people to take you seriously and you're looking for abundance to come into your life, you've got to feel like that. And I assure you that if you're walking around outside in your pajamas, you've given up on yourself, so you're not going to pull in much. And I know that that's probably going to get me a few middle fingers there, but I've just got to point these out, right? It's something that I've noticed, but it's not okay to be walking around outside in your pajamas. You know what I mean? Unless it's a life-threatening kind of deal, yes, but I'm talking grocery store, bank. I've never noticed this before. But take 5 seconds, invest in yourself, feel better about yourself, right? And do those things. But that's what I think overall is going on. I think that you've got success here. I think you've got victory here. I think you're critiquing routines. I think you're getting your vitality back. I think you need to stick with things. See things through, even if they don't finish out the way that you want. Be at the end of the week, check off your to-do list. And if it's not done, figure out where, you know, you can critique the next week. This is a progressive kind of thing. And what my goal is here is to get you forward on a week-to-week basis here. Not give up on things because life takes over. Very rarely does a to-do list go out like it was written. It just doesn't. Life critiques it for us. But we need to be at the helm and not let it be, you know, dragged all over the place. Hold ourselves accountable for things. That's what I've got. I think, too, there's some of you, I think, are really concentrated on something, and some of you, I think, are really confused by other things, right? So I would sit in the confusion. I would really sit in it. It doesn't mean anything's wrong. It may mean that something is going to bring you greater clarity, right? You may not just have it yet. It may go over a little bit. So I would give it some time, right? The Hermit in reverse is just saying, don't fight things. If you're tired, take a break. If you need time out to yourself, take time out to yourself. Don't overextend yourself here, because this is when we cage ourselves into the corner. This is when we're okay and have boundaries in place and say, you know what, I would love to help you, but my plate is overfilling. I'm over the legal limit for anything else that I can take on, right? And sometimes that just takes some good old-fashioned strength to say that and be honest with yourself. And this can be, you know, someone asking you to help them with something and you just can't. You need to put yourself on the forefront first, right? Otherwise, you're running around town in your pajamas, right? So there you go. I hope that I helped you in some way.